Okay, all right. Well, there are two important things before I go on to my slide. One is the timing of my speech reflects about my importance, but not about the topic. So I can assure you, you will hear nothing of what you have heard throughout the day today about data, science, and measurement. Also, my presence always amongst my friend is overwhelming. You can measure it by how many people are outside the hall than inside. So today is also Thursday and Madison report, right, Sam? It's not a good day for a media owner. I'm the first media owner to speak at this dais all alone, not in the company. I was supposed to be accompanied by Rohit Gupta, who ran away for some reason. Normally, people don't stay longer with people who run the news channels. So today also is a day when, on Thursday, when you get the data. My friend Sunil Lula has just gone out. He said what all that news channels can buy and even dissect it further to understand the content, and then the shouting on the 9 p.m. news will happen at a particular time to gain more rating. That we'll discover later. But it's a very unusual day for a media owner to speak on, not on data. My friend Vikram always tells me that you are a good storyteller, so I'm going to tell you a story. And the easiest thing to be interesting, what I topic that I choose today, is to be interested in something. As a content creator, we are always about knowing about you than more about us. So usually people who work in the field of art, culture, and media entertainment are interesting people. They are curious about the surrounding and interested in people and things as they see. They tell stories. So today I'm going to give myself up to this house. Judge me on the statement that I present today. And I'm not going to present any statement about the SAM projections about the next year. If they're interesting enough, or are you interested in this? But first of all, I would like to tell you a story. Also because Vikram often tells that after 8 p.m. we can tell better stories. So I'm going to talk about a story today, and the story is not about what is obvious. In my next 7-10 slides that I'm going to show it to you is not something that is very obvious. And what Sam, you rightly said, what is not very obvious. So it all started almost about 8 years ago. It was 2:45 in the afternoon, and with tremors some 6 miles under the Earth's surface, and likes of which has never been felt before, more than a century. 60 miles away from that place, the seismograph shows some crazy number. It was 9 on the Richter scale. Less than half an hour later, the first waves crashed on the Japan shore. Initially, it was 20 feet, went up to 30, then 40, and then 60. You know what happens next. In a few hours, over 200 square mile area was all gone. The devastation was everywhere. The entire area was covered with mud, water, and debris. Over 20,000 people that day were dead in Japan. Now, if something like this happens to any country, what's the first thing that comes to our mind? About the human tragedy. And how are we going to rebuild the place? What will happen to our economy? Particular question that has been there for a very long time in our mind for last 1 year. When after GST and demonetization and all that, right? This is the slide of the Guardian newspaper, which said that Japan's economy is heading to a free fall. And my slide is very important for people who are thinking that the GDP or the economic side of the world, these kind of events determine what you are going to do next. A few months later, the World Bank tallied the total cost of the disaster to $250 billion. roughly the size of the GDP of Greece. The Sendai quake on March 11, 2011 was the costliest disaster ever recorded in history before. But that's not part of my story alone. The most interesting part for those of us who are interested in business and in politics and economy is this. Larry Summers, the famous economist and who taught me at Harvard, appeared that day on TV. And he said, this tragedy would help lift the economy of Japan. When the rest of the world was crying that Japan is devastated, he said, this is a very good sign for Japan's economy. Sure enough, there would be a couple of months of distress, but recovery efforts would boost demand, consumption, and employment. Larry was right. The next year, Japan's economy grew by over 2%. For Japan's economy to grow at the rate of 2% is a big, big deal. The story about a tragedy leading to economic growth is a great story. And when we look at the data of what's going on in demonetization, GST, we did not figure out that why, even after all that, the advertising industry has grown, Sam, which you have presented in the last 2 years, that it has grown. We all thought it is a devastation. You don't need to break a glass window to start an economic activity. When I was in this class, somebody said that, you know, maybe to start an economic activity, you should break the neighbor's window. Because if the neighbor's window is broken, he'll call a glass guy, he'll call a carpenter, the whole economic cycle will move on. That's not the way to do economic activity. I'm not sure. As a storyteller, and why I told you this story, is that as a storyteller, we look at opportunity in all adversity. We are looking at getting even finer things done because maybe in bad economic time, people are looking at some nice stuff to entertain. The success of Big Boss in the last season, Raj, is a great example of creating an out-of-the-box content. The story that I narrated in Japan is a great story from writers and journal point of view, but it's not only interesting a story because it happened, because finally it's an outlier story, something that does not happen on a usual day. And as a journalist, that's what we chase, that's what we report. Running a news organization, I can tell you, is the hardest thing to do. One thing is to look at the data, and one thing is to look at what goes into that data. In all creative business, we think a good creative work can only come from having a good amount of money. Isn't it? The latest series of the morning show on the Apple TV, I'm told each episode is over $15 million. All put together, they burnt about close to $85 million on 8-part series. Right. It won Emmy, I don't know. Raj will know better from entertainment side. So, data, I'll come later, but doing a good creative requires courage. And courage is not all about taking risks. Everybody can take risks. Courage is about doing things when you fully know and acknowledge what are the consequences of doing it. And yet you go ahead and do it. This is what we do at news channels. We know what are the risks. The next video that I'm going to show it to you, which is my first video today, is about a series that we launched about 5 years back. And that's a very interesting story, which some of you were not there at the launch of this. So no sane company, I can tell you, will ever get into this kind of indulgence. Because what you do may not give you rating. And my friends at Madison will bring down the advertising rate by negotiating with my team, right? That year, when we launched this show, we spent 30% of our total communication budget and planning budget. Shekhar Kapoor, by his own admission, got further immortalized by this series. He personally told me that when he made Bandit Queen and Elizabeth, he was more recognized by what happened in Pradhan Mantri 1. This series is now in series 2, and I can tell you he is even more immortalized. I am going to show you a clip which has not been released in the market, which will come almost 3 weeks from now. Just watch this video.
चारु दादा, कोई भी क्रांति जनता से अलग होके सफल नहीं हो सकता है। अरे की छोटा छोटा हथियार जमा करना, लोगों को चुन चुन के मारो ऐसा बोलना, ये हम लोगों को गलत दिशा में ले जा रहा है।
जो भी नीति अपनाई जा रही है उसके बारे में दूसरे कॉम्रेड से बातचीत हुई है और सभी आर्म स्ट्रगल मतलब सशस्त्र संग्राम के लिए।
जो आपका हाँ में हाँ मिला रहा है ना, उसके बारे में आप बोल रहे हैं कि वो कलेक्टिव डिसीजन है, वो सहमत है आपसे दादा, जो आपके हाँ में हाँ मिला रहा है बस।
कानू, तुम हमारे फैसले का विरोध कर लेनिन के फैसले का विरोध कर रहे हो। मुझे लगता है आर्म स्ट्रगल सशस्त्र संग्राम तुरंत होना चाहिए, धड़ाधड़ी।
This series, the second part series on the problems that ailed India, and this particular episode that you have seen from the Naxalite movement. The producer who went to work in the field of the Jharkhand was almost killed by the Naxalite. He was in their captivity for good 14 days without anything until they realized that he's actually a journalist, and then they released him. But when we made the series one, my fellow broadcaster quickly copied it, put a similar name, and reflected intellectual bankruptcy by hiring a non-working actor to hit the show. I tell you what happened next, and that's the real story. That particular show, the second one, which was a copycat, got more rating than this particular show. It's a different matter that Pradhan Mantri 1 got 9.1 rating in IMD, and Exchange for Media News Broadcaster Award actually awarded the copycat as the best show. That's called courage. And that's why it is interesting. You know, the collective strength of this show, I'm coming to the next slide, that in the reality television side, the format of this show, this particular show, which I'm going to show it to you, has never been done before. Can you please play the video, please?
Saas bahu aur saasish har dopahar.
So this particular show was the first time done about 18 years, 17 years back, if I'm not wrong, when Star News got launched. Every single day, 5 days a week, or now 7 days a week, it is the number one show. And what is unique about this show is that they show the narrator is not the center character, but the people whom she's reporting about, the character of the real shows, are the reporters. Several of my fellow broadcasters tried to copycat, but what is more important about this, that, go to the next slide please, that this show is so powerful that Sam, none of your political friend will ever do a press conference, launch anything, or do a rally during that time of the show. Because the broadcasters are not going to drop that show. And if that is the case, they are not going to address that constituency. I don't think so, other than politicians knows better than any market. They are the best marketeer. So, what is more important for us to understand that the kind of creativity that particular producer has done is far more important than the, what the data just represent. Look at what is happening in the Indian polity. Next slide, please. Now, that is why I say that this, the most of the time, the simple ranking that, whether the Pradhan Mantri ranking or the Saas Bahu Saazish ranking, reveals actually far less than what it shows. So it's important to note that simple ranking of the channels actually does not matter as far as the creativity goes. Probably it hides more than it reveals, and this ambiguity has helped us in believing millions of gods. I'll show you the next video and you'll understand what I'm talking about.
स्वागत है। आज प्रधानमंत्री मोदी ने पहली चुनावी रैली को संबोधित किया, पहली बार चुनावी मैदान में उतरे। अमित शाह ने तो मोर्चा पहले से ही संभाल रखा है। क्या मोदी के भाषण से अब दिल्ली की तस्वीर बदलेगी? क्या अमित शाह की मेहनत ने दिल्ली का सियासी भ्रमजाल तोड़ा है? रोज के आंकड़े, रोज का मूड, और इस मूड को बारीकी से।
नाउ वी वर डूइंग ओपिनियन पोल, वी डिड एन ओपिनियन पोल वेयर वी शोड आप इज गेटिंग 58% ऑफ वोट्स एंड बीजेपी इज गोइंग टू गेट लेस देन 30% ऑफ द वोट, फॉलोड इमीडिएटली बाय दैट, बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली व्हेन इट दिस हैपेंड ऑन द फर्स्ट डे आई गॉट अ कॉल, एंड व्हेन यू गेट अ कॉल यू ट्राई टू रेक्टिफाई दैट, सो आई स्टार्टेड डूइंग अ डेली पोल, हाउ द पोलस्टर्स आर रिपोर्टिंग अबाउट द मूवमेंट ऑफ द वोटर्स शेयर. What happened in the peak of activity, of polarized activity, that actually the figure moved in the favor of BJP, it became from 30% to 34%. But look at what happens next.
अभी जो वोट है और जो एबीपी न्यूज जो सर्वे करवा रहे हैं उसमें जो अंतर था 20% का, वो अब घटकर करीब आ गया 8% से 10%. क्या उससे आपको कुछ चिंता होती है?
मुझे आपके सर्वे पे भरोसा नहीं है. चुनाव के नतीजों का इंतजार कीजिएगा.
सर्वे पे ही भरोसा नहीं है आपको? सर्वे पे आप सीधा सवाल उठा देते हैं.
मैं आप सी वोटर का, आपका सी वोटर ही है ना?
हाँ.
आप उनका ट्रैक रिकॉर्ड उठा लीजिए पिछले 5 साल का.
हाँ.
कभी भी उनको उन्होंने सही नहीं बताया. अभी पता नहीं हरियाणा के अंदर उन्होंने कितनी 83 सीट दी थी बीजेपी को.
हाँ.
तो हाँ. उनका थोड़ा सा जो सर्वे है वो बीजेपी की तरफ टिल्टेड रहता है.
सो लाइक टिपिकल पॉलिटिशियन ही शूटिंग द मैसेंजर सेइंग दैट यू नो यू आर रॉन्ग, 32% इज बॉदरिंग हिम. ही इज गेटिंग 54% बट इट्स स्टिल बॉदरिंग हिम एंड ही सेज यू आर नॉट क्रेडिबल. Then who is credible? Just see the next slide. So this is what the result was, this is what we projected, and this is what happened. Go to the next slide, please. He gave credit to the Hanumanji. Instead of all the poll that showed that he is getting 54% of voters. The problem with most of the reporting that we do is that to look at these outliers, and it's not an easy job to do. I will show you a few video which is very short, but it's the interesting thing of how the Hindi as a language can work as a magic. Can you please play the next video?
और इनसे समझते हैं कि आखिर इनका दर्द है क्या? 45-46 दिन से परिवार को छोड़ करके महिलाएं छोटे छोटे बच्चों के साथ यहाँ बैठी है. आप देखिए वहाँ अनशन पर वो महिला बैठी हुई है, उनकी तबीयत कुछ नासाज भी लग रही है. क्यों ना आइए उनसे बात करते हैं, उन्हीं से समझते हैं क्या तकलीफ है कि ये अपने आप को दर्द देने पर उतारू हुआ है. कैसी हैं आप? हैं? तबीयत ठीक है? हैं? कितने दिन हो गए बैठे हुए आपको?
आज 30 दिन है.
30 दिन?
हाँ.
अच्छा एक बात बताइए.
हाँ.
ऐसा कौन सा दर्द है जिस दर्द को बताने के लिए आप अपने आप को दर्द दे रही हैं?
पूरे हिंदुस्तान का ही है, हम गरीब लोगों.
सो ही आस्क्ड कि ऐसा कौन सा दर्द है जिस दर्द को दबाने के लिए अपने आप को आप इतना दर्द दे रहे हैं. नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर फेलो हु वेंट ऑन फॉर रिपोर्टिंग, दिस इज द वन एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट वी डिड एट एबीपी न्यूज, इज दैट वी सेड एवरीबडी इज रिपोर्टिंग अबाउट शाहीन बाग. इन फैक्ट व्हेन विक्रम कॉल्ड मी अप फॉर दिस स्पीकिंग आई वॉज स्टक इन दैट जैम एंड ही सेड रोहित हैज ड्रॉप्ड आउट, कैन यू डू अ स्टैंड अलोन थिंग. आई सेड ओके लवली, यू नो आई एम स्टक हियर, आई विल मे बी रिपोर्टिंग अबाउट दिस. Srivardhan, who is reporting from here, is an NSD-trained actor. He is probably one of the most recognized faces of Indian television because he does a daily soap which comes at 11 p.m. every night on the crime. He does acting in that. To send him to report on a matter of Shaheen Bagh was not a small thing to do. It was quite a courageous thing because he has never reported before. So he framed these sentences and this particular video became viral, and this was remember the next day when the two journos were beaten in the Shaheen Bagh itself and he dared to go inside. This program did well amongst the sensible audience. The next video is also a first time video in history, in the history of India. Just watch it for a moment.
मैं पहली इंटरव्यू चैनल को दे रहा हूं जो आपकी है.
35 राज्य सरकार को गिराया गया राज्यपालों के रिपोर्टों के आधार पर.
खुली आंख से और खुले कान से ये कहता हूं, भय का वातावरण है। बहुत सी बातें मैंने मीडिया को नहीं कही है। यू विल बी शॉक्ड, अमेज्ड एंड सरप्राइज्ड। देश के 70 साल के इतिहास में ऐसा नहीं हुआ। आपको बहुत कम रिवील कर रहा हूँ, मेरे अंदर दर्द ज्यादा है।
पार्थो चटर्जी बोल रहे हैं, द गवर्नर मस्ट विजिट ब्यूटीफुल प्लेसेस इन वेस्ट।
सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट इंटरव्यू ऑफ ए सिटिंग गवर्नर ऑफ इंडिया टू अ प्रेस। व्हाट हैपेंस नेक्स्ट? दैट रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड स्टार्टेड चेजिंग इट। दिस वीडियो बिकम वायरल। ममता बनर्जी कंप्लेंट सेइंग दैट यू कैन नॉट इंटरव्यू अ गवर्नर। द गवर्नर वेंट वन स्टेप फर्दर, ही गेव फर्दर इंटरव्यू टू ऑल द न्यूज़पेपर्स, एंड नाउ द गवर्नर इंटरव्यू हैज बिकम अ फैशन। In this interview was done about close to 1.5 back. Last week on Rajat Sharma's show, the Kerala governor appeared in Aapki Adalat. It's a very entertaining show. If you get time, watch it. Now, these unprecedented coverage of Indian polity has one thing that happens to us with Sam, is called dropping of the spots. And I'm not saying this. This is happening even in America. The advertiser and advertising agencies are never valuing what a live television has done to the business of advertising. In any way, Sam, the Netflix and the Amazon Prime are not allowing the advertising to place, but so is the live telecast and the drama of the politicians all around us. It is a sheer loss to the advertising growth which you can project in the next year. Indian News TV, by internal estimates, have dropped about over $3 billion of advertising this year alone. In my next two video, that's what we did. So we said that because we have to run ads and we have to report a lot, we made a few videos which went viral on the social media and on the websites. Each day, it received over 1.5 million views on video, on the digital. Let's play the video, please.
नमस्कार दोस्तों, आज बात दिल्ली के दंगल की। दिल्ली विधानसभा चुनाव को लेकर अब लगभग साफ हो गया है कि मुकाबला कैसे कैसे हो रहा है। और सबसे अधिक नजर अगर कहीं लगी थी तो वो नई दिल्ली सीट पर लगी थी, जहां पर अरविंद केजरीवाल अपना हैट्रिक लगाने की कोशिश इस बार करने वाले हैं। दिल्ली के मुख्यमंत्री हैं, 2013 में 15 में जीत चुके हैं, 2020 में वो तीसरी बार चुनावी मैदान में हैं और मुख्यमंत्री के तौर पर लड़ रहे हैं। साफ बात थी कि अरविंद केजरीवाल, जिनको पेंट किया गया बीते 5 साल के अंदर कि वो डिस्ट्रक्टिव पॉलिटिक्स करते हैं, वो धरना पॉलिटिक्स करते हैं, आज की तारीख में जब मैं आपसे बात कर रहा हूँ, क्या उनके सामने आने वाली दोनों बड़ी पार्टियाँ, भारतीय जनता पार्टी और कांग्रेस, इन 5 सालों में क्या कोई भी ऐसा नेता तैयार कर सकी जो अरविंद केजरीवाल को मुकाबला दे सके?
वाला माल 40 रुपए किलो।
इस बार की हवा केजरीवाल की है।
मेन मुद्दा केजरीवाल रहेगा।
बीजेपी
थड़ी की, मेरे पास वोटर आईडी नहीं है।
नहीं
तो कौन लग रहा है आपको? अच्छा,
अब तुम्हें बता दूं तो भूलेगी फिर वहाँ।
नाउ दीस वायरल वीडियोस एंड मिलियंस ऑफ व्यूज आर एब्सोल्युटली गोइंग अनमोनेटाइज्ड और नॉट सो मच मोनेटाइज्ड बाय द स्ट्रक्चर्ड way in which we do advertising sales. And what you rightly said in your presentation today, that selling TV and digital together is a new mantra for the success. TV is a very hard business to do. And the problem of the measurement today, whatever that we do report, is these extrapolated numbers. The moment we start getting the real numbers from TV plus digital together, it would be a different thing. So what matters today is not the nature of the product, but the price in the market today. With this, I come to the last part of my presentation, which is why we judge everything with number. What price is the product that determines alone its value? It's interesting to see that what we don't see. And here are my few questions that you can take some interest in. Can you judge the quality of an educational institution by its number of graduates? Or how many people are graduating every year? Does a good doctor means that there is a good care? And does a high viewership of a television channel means a good programming? The economy is growing. Therefore, the country is doing fine. Are these statements in itself true or false? And that's what interests us as a journalist to find out more. Advertising dollars are chasing mindless numbers. Because of this chase, a number news channel and journalists are compelled to chase stories which they shall do far less or may not do at all. Because advertising follow numbers, a British think tank estimates that it destroys 7 times of the value. Producing good contents require good people, and many of them, unlike ever before. The thing to think here, Sam, is that why is price have not kept with the cost of the content? Cable operators and DPOs are making more money today than any content creators. In fact, content creators does not have much incentive to do much. It's a curious thing to see that the plumbers today are making more money than the people who supply water. Our industry, as you rightly said, is bank on a good GDP, good growth. All politicians love GDP. To me, GDP is not a very high indicator of the growth. That's an interesting fact that if you travel around, you'll find no vacant seat in the airline today. Hotels are sold out, including this one when I checked in today. And as our PM rightly said today, that yesterday, that we are all buying these cars, holidaying abroad, where the money is coming from. But they say GDP is not good. GDP is actually good for very, very good for journalists like us. We tell you everything that you may already know. Therefore, what I want to leave you with an interesting fact, and all content creators face every day. Producing good content is not like producing coffee machines. Something in life always resists efficiency. No matter what you do, a good quality work can never be made by buying like cheap or putting more money into it. And Mozart's 14th string is an example of that. Even 400 years later, the same amount of people are required to produce a good music. As you rightly said, Sam, that investment in brand and making it premium is the right thing to do. Sasta, as Manoj Kohli, what he said today, is a very relative term to me. When you're too obsessed with productivity, you don't see a real value of what is being there. Productivity and efficiency, I believe, are for robots, because humans like to do experiments. The next video, I have taken a permission from my colleague to show. It is not from my channel, but one of our colleagues did an experiment by bringing an aggressiveness of Hindi into English news channels. And it changed the way the television is seen across, not only television, but the way the public discourse happens. Point is that you may or may not agree with him, and show you may not like or like. It does not matter. What matters is that what it has started.
Why can't you stand up for Janagana Mana? Why don't you stand up for Janagana Mana? What's your problem with it? Why can't you stand up for 52 seconds? Why can't you? Why? See, the entire Rotary Club or school. Why can't you stand up for 52 seconds? Why can't you stand up for 52 seconds? Why can't you? Today, because I'll tell you why. You hear me, then I'll tell you why. Can I tell you why? Then you stop, I'll tell you why. I can't shout over you. I'll tell you why, Mr. Pathan. Don't be an anti-national.
No matter what you think about and what your views are, you watch him, you have an opinion about him, and you share that. For me, when I look at the show, and when most of us know Arnab personally, we know that these are the two different things that what we see on television and what he is as an individual. Creating a show like this requires courage. What it has done, that is the 9 p.m., either it is a noise or is a one-sided video that has proliferated across the networks, across India, and that's a revolution, Sam, and that is why it is interesting. In the advertising business, Sam, you always compare China, America, and all that, and now I'm coming to my last two slides. We may be closer to China faster than you think, only if media buying and selling is beyond numbers. It shall assess its real value, which is hidden beyond the numbers. And we must know what we want and why we want it. Now it is up to us to consider what is the right way to measure a good content, data, or curiosity, or both. Does growth means progress? And more fundamentally, what makes life truly worthwhile if we are not interested in any specifics? Thank you very much for listening to me.
Thank you.